Rick Skillman.
This is John Pace.
How you doing?
Yeah, you're at NAMM 2013, and Dunlop TV decided to stop by and have a little chat about speakers and what they can do for you. Keep in mind that there are a million variables, but hopefully this information we provide today will steer you in the right direction to make the right choices.
So if you take a look at the guitar speaker, there are a few things, you know, within its makeup that affect the tone. So you have the cone itself here, the membrane. There's the voice coil, which attaches the cone to the motor, which is in the back. And of course, the motor is made up of a magnet and a big hunk of metal. And these three things together, plus a couple of others, really do affect the tonality of the speaker. So there are various variables that we can change and modify and tweak to get the tone that you like. You take the creamback or the original greenback. They're both ceramic magnet guitar speakers. Now ceramic, it has the characteristic of being quite aggressive. It's a gritty, in-your-face magnet material. It's a medium-weight ceramic magnet, the G12M. That's what the M stands for. And then, of course, we've got the G12H, which is a heavyweight ceramic magnet, which gives it a slightly different balance of tone, a little bit more low-end, and a little bit more high-end too, actually, and some more power handling. If you compare and contrast that to some of our Alnico speakers, I'm sure you're familiar with the Alnico Blue, which has been around since the late 50s. It's the speaker that sits in the Vox AC30 that would have sat behind the Beatles back in the day. Also, people like Brian May use it. It's got more of a relaxed feel.
What the Alnico does, it compresses in a way, and it gives you that buttery mid-range. You know, I talk to people all the time. It's like, oh, you like Brad Paisley? He uses the Alnico Blue, and then he's really big on the Alnico Gold because he's at concert volume and he's humping on these things. And he wanted something, he wanted pop. So we came out with the Alnico Gold 50 watts. And we get a lot of questions at Celestion regarding what makes a difference. You know, am I an Alnico guy? Am I a ceramic magnet guy? And what you want to do is you want to think in your head, right, this is the sound I like. This is the player I am. And then start associating the product with the player. So it's like, oh, I grew up listening personally to Ed Van Halen, was my guy.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So, and he's a greenback player. Coincidentally, we have the signature EVH, our first signature series speaker in our 90-year history. Your, Slayer and Slipknot guy will go up to like a K100 or a T75 or some of those classic speakers. And the reason they like those is because they're drop tuning. And they're just like, they're living down in that C register where it's just, you know, knocking the pants off your ass. And that's a totally different vibe, you know. So those guys want to go for high power, big bottom end, and just big grunting metal. And then some guys will do some funky stuff, like they'll take two T75s and two vintage 30s in an X pattern. The vintage 30 is firing that required mid-range, so they still have their presence on stage. And then the T75 or 100 winds it out a bit and just gives you that nice nut kick to throw you over the fence. And then you get the rootsy rock guys are like, hey, you know, I like a bit of twang and jangle, you know, Tom Petty kind of thing. And that's the Alnico, and you're going to want to use that. That'll be the blue or the gold. And then sometimes those guys, they'll mix that with an H30, a G12 H30 or a greenback, and that's because they fill in the gaps nicely. We get a lot of funky questions, and we see a lot of things on the internet, and one of the most popular misconceptions, I don't know if you agree, John, is that people associate headroom with power. And you could argue to a degree that can be the case, but honestly, we can make a 1 watt speaker that'll stay brilliant and clean until the moment it goes poof, and we can make a 100 watt speaker that could be tickled with 2 watts and break up.
Absolutely.
The second one is, when you have two speakers with different power handling, it is not the sum of both of those speakers that make your cabinet's total power handling.
if you have a 15 watt and a 50 watt speaker for some reason in the same box, you want to double the power of the 15 watt, and that is the most of that cabinet can handle.
Yeah, it's twice the lowest power speaker.
Yeah. The internet's a big world out there, so you just got to sort out good information from bad. And the best way to do it is you can contact the Celestion website. You can get a hold of Dr. Decibel, and the contact details are on there for any of us.
That information coupled with the information you get from these, from your ears, because that's the best advice we could give anybody, is to trust their ears.
Yeah, 10-4 on that, yeah.